I did a video covering all of the games that are going to be covered at E3, but now I want to go over rumors. Things that, well, unfortunately, they're probably not true. What is up, everybody? Chaos here, and E3 is right around the corner. Let me know in the comment section, what reveal are you most looking forward to? What gameplay do you want to see? And today, we're going to go over 10 rumors that, unfortunately, are probably not real, and they were probably tricking some people. So sit back and let's get into it. Kicking off our list is the fact that new consoles are coming this year. E3 is right around the corner. Just like every year, there's tons of rumors floating around about what we should expect, but today, well, today we have to get some truth out of them, and the first one is the obvious one. The PS5 and the Xbox 2 are coming this year. Now, there's a lot of hype around the next generation of consoles, there always is, and we're slowly getting a lot of additional information about them. There's some rumors going around about the consoles coming by the end of this year. Put simply, there is no way this happens. Just think about it. The year is already halfway over, and if these consoles were really going to launch by the end of the year, we would have been hearing a lot more about them. Plus, Sony isn't even having a conference this year, so the chances of them revealing and launching a PS5 by 2020's end are slim to none. Microsoft may reveal some details about their new line of Xbox consoles, but I doubt they're going to be launching this year either. Put simply, once again, the ninth console generation is still at least another year or two away. We may get info about them at E3, but they won't launch until at least 2020. Next up is there is a Nintendo Switch Pro. There have been a lot of rumors floating around about an improved version of the Nintendo Switch called the Switch Pro. Now, this would definitely make sense given that Microsoft and Sony both have improved versions of their respective consoles in the form of the Xbox One and the PS4 Pro, but the rumors to support the Switch Pro are slim. In fact, they are somewhat conflicting with other rumors about a different Switch remodel. According to reports from Bloomberg about a month ago, Nintendo is working on a new version of their console called the Switch Lite, which will be a cheaper version of the Nintendo Switch. However, they are not working on a Switch Pro. Bloomberg did state that Nintendo was planning to make universal hardware upgrades to the Switch in the near future, but there would not be a standalone Switch Pro. And I guess we'll find out for sure at Nintendo's conference, but it's looking like the Switch Pro isn't actually real. This month's giveaway is for a brand new PlayStation 4 console. All you have to do to enter is like the video, make sure you're subscribed to the channel, turn on those notifications, and tweet me why you want to win it with your Twitter handle included. At number 8, Elder Scrolls 6 will be shown. Now, I think this should be a no-brainer, but there's a lot of people who think Bethesda will be showing off the 6th mainline Elder Scrolls game during their conference. I don't agree. Aside from the fact that Bethesda made it very clear at last year's E3 that Elder Scrolls 6 was very early in development and wouldn't be ready for a few years, you have to think of how much of a disaster 2019 has been for them. Fallout 76? Complete failure. And Bethesda has been doing damage control ever since. And in case you didn't remember, Todd Howard himself stated that Elder Scrolls 6 was going to be built on the same engine as Fallout 76, which was not a good way to get people excited. Now, personally, I think Bethesda is in a bit of a panic right now about their next big release, and they're going to need all the time they can get to get it right. If we see anything of Elder Scrolls 6, it won't be more than a short cinematic or maybe some concept art or screenshots. There's no way that Elder Scrolls 6 is actually being featured during Bethesda's conference this year. Next up is a new Silent Hill. I wish this was true. This is wishful thinking, and even though a lot of people are talking about it, I'm going to put it on here with a painful sigh. As much as I would love to believe that Konami would surprise us and announce a new Silent Hill at this year's E3, I think it's safe to say that the series is dead, at least for the time being. Following the very dramatic and very public fallout between Konami and Hideo Kojima, the director of the now-canceled Silent Hills, it's very obvious that Konami has stepped away from the series and really, I mean, they stepped away from making good games altogether, honestly. So as much as I would love to convince myself that a new Silent Hill is coming, I highly doubt it actually is. Call of Duty Modern Warfare won't have a season pass. Now, this is more specific to Call of Duty, but I'm going to put it in the video because we're allegedly going to be getting more information about the upcoming Modern Warfare at E3 this week. Following Modern Warfare's reveal, Infinity Ward stated the game would not feature a traditional season pass, which many people interpreted as no season pass. But I think we need to be very careful when talking about that. You have to look at the specific wording of what Infinity Ward said. They didn't say no season pass. They said no traditional season pass, which is very similar to what Treyarch said last year before revealing the disastrous Black Ops pass to go along with Black Ops 4. Now, I'm sure we'll get a season pass question answered at E3, but if I were you, I would hold on and just see, because there's going to be some kind of post-launch DLC model, and if there wasn't going to be a season pass at all, Infinity Ward would have straight up said that. The fact they threw the word in traditional, well, there's a little concern there, so we're going to have to wait and see. Cracking into the top five, George R.R. Martin's game will be shown. This is a rumor that may have flown under the radar for a lot of people, but for those that don't know, Mr. George Martin, writer of the Game of Thrones, is reportedly working with developers from Software, creators of Dark Souls, Bloodborne, and Sekiro, to create a Japanese game featuring an open-world horse riding and from Software signature Soul Styles combat. Now, some rumors even state the game has been in development for 3 years already and will be published by Bandai Namco. While I do think the rumors are credible and there really is going to be a collaboration between Martin and From Software, I don't think it's going to be shown off at E3. After all, From Software just released Sekiro Shadows Die Twice, and they're known to be a company that takes their time with their games and only starts showing things off when the release is close. The game may have been in development for 3 years already, but if it's really going to be as big as reports say, it's going to need more time in the oven and definitely more time away from Sekiro in order to get the optimal amount of hype. The rumors do state that the game may be revealed during Microsoft's E3 conference, so maybe I'll be proved wrong. But personally, I think we would have heard something right now if that were the case. I truly hope I'm proved wrong because the game sounds epic, but I do not see it happening this year. At number four, Halo Infinite will launch this year. Now, we know that Microsoft will be showing off a ton of Halo stuff this year, be it in the form of Halo Infinite or the upcoming Halo PC ports via the Master Chief Collection. But one thing I can promise you is that when Halo Infinite gets its release date, it's probably not going to be 2019. Looking through Microsoft's history with their two big shooter franchises, Halo and Gears of War, they rarely ever release games in the same year. Gears of 5 is coming out later this year, we know that, and that alone should be enough to shut down the rumors of Halo Infinite also coming. But I could go a step further and say that if Halo Infinite was really coming this year, we would have seen a lot more about it. After all, Halo is a much bigger name in gaming than Gears, but with all the Gears 5 marketing that's been going around, you would think that Microsoft would be pushing Infinite even harder if it was coming. Now, unless Microsoft plans on doing a surprise reveal in a 2019 launch, which I seriously doubt, you should probably expect Halo Infinite to launch in 2020. At number three, Metroid Prime 4 will be shown. Now, this is one I hope I'm wrong about, but looking at the facts and the timeline of everything, I think I'm right. For those that don't know, Metroid Prime 4 was revealed at E3 2017, but then in January of this year, Nintendo released a video stating that development had been completely restarted due to the project straying too far from the original version. So, As much as I and other people would like to think that Nintendo will surprise us with some gameplay about Metroid Prime 4 during their conference, it's not going to happen. After all, the new version of the game has only been in development for about 6 months now, so even if they were able to show anything off they were working on, it would probably be really hard, really rough, and probably hardly worth showing. Now, I think Nintendo is going to hold on to their work and maybe show something off later this year at Nintendo Direct, or maybe even at E3 2020, but I highly doubt Metroid Prime 4 will make an appearance in any fashion this year. Nintendo may mention it or give a little update on the development, but there's no way they could actually show footage. At number two, Bayonetta 3 will be shown. Now, this one is kind of in the same world as Metroid Prime 4, since Bayonetta 3 was another Nintendo exclusive revealed back in 2017. But the details of why this one won't be shown, well, they're a little weirder. Now, Nintendo straight up told the world that Metroid Prime 4 was going to be restarted. The work on Bayonetta 3 has almost always seemingly been troubled. The game was revealed in late 2017 with the release slated for this year. But in April of this year, Nintendo quietly changed the release window on their website from this year to a mysterious to be announced, which was not good for fans. Now, I can definitely respect the company wanting to take their time with the game to make sure it's as good as possible when launch day comes, but the fact that Nintendo removed the game's release date just a couple months ago doesn't bode well for any showings at E3. Now, it is worth noting that Nintendo stated that Switch ports of Bayonetta 1 and 2 were also in development and were supposed to be released alongside Bayonetta 3, so it's possible the delays were related to the development of those games and not the new one. But from what we know right now, I think it's pretty unlikely that Bayonetta 3 will be shown off at E3. If you're enjoying the content, make sure to drop a like on the video. Make sure you're subscribed to the channel with post notifications on so you always get alerted when a new video goes up and you can get that elusive first comment. And at number one today, Death Stranding, Ghost of Tsushima, and Last of Us Part 2. Finishing off things is a group entry of three games that I can promise you, well, I can't promise, but I don't think they'll be anywhere at E3. Now, this should be obvious due to the fact that Sony isn't going to make an appearance at the conference, and recently they've been taking to kind of doing their own shows, but I've still seen some people saying that Sony will do some kind of little surprise thing with their upcoming exclusives during E3. I don't see it happening. After all, we already got the release date for Death Stranding, and we pretty much know that Last of Us Part 2 and Ghost of Tsushima are not ready for public to see yet, so it would make sense that Sony doesn't want to have a conference where they just tread over information that we already know. They kind of have a habit of showing off the same games over and over at the last few E3 conferences, so it makes sense that they have nothing new to share that they don't show up, right? We already got our release date for Death Stranding, so I think it's safe to say we're going to have to wait a little longer for the rest of the games. And I'm pretty sure Last of Us 2 is probably going to come at the tail end of the PS4 cycle or be a launch title for the PS5. And there you have it. Those are 10 E3 rumors that I'm afraid just probably aren't true. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I'm wrong on all of them. I hope. Fingers crossed. You guys, let me know what you're most looking forward to. Drop a like. Make sure you subscribe. Turn on those post notifications. And I'll see you soon.